So you have a scene inside Unreal Engine 4, and you want to create your own custom HDRIs based on the environment that you have inside of your scene. We're going to cover that process today in this quick tip video on how to create HDRIs from your scenes in Unreal Engine 4. Let's go ahead and get started. In order to have accurate reflections in Unreal Engine 4, we need to project some kind of lighting data back into our scene. Now, generally speaking, there are two common places to control this, and that's with skylights and reflection captures. However, by themselves, they will work fairly good, but we're going to need some kind of lighting information in order to project that ambient light back into our scene. So we do this through an HDRI, or a high dynamic range image. Now, once we have that HDRI, we can then apply it into our scene, specifically on our skylights and our reflection captures. So to start with, let's actually see the effects of using an HDRI on our scene. And to do that, I'm actually just going to focus on skylights. And we'll do the other process here a little later. So I'm going to jump back to our scene, and I'm going to fly actually up into this corner up here where I've got this SMS color checker. Now, the thing that I want to do is I want to focus on this. It's a chrome ball. Actually, and if you notice that the reflections are completely black, that's because we don't really have anything affecting in our scene. So what I'm going to do here is actually go up into our lights, and I've got two skylights. Now, the one that I want to focus on here is this HDRI. Now, if you don't have a skylight in your scene, it's very simple. Just go over to lights and drag a skylight into your scene. There you go. You can see the effects of blowing it out. Now, what's happening here is actually this skylight is using our captured scene. So I'm going to go ahead and delete this. And go back to the one that I have set up here. So the first thing that I want to do is set it to stationary or movable. The reason for that is if I just have it on static and I apply an HDRI to this, I'm not going to see the effects in editor until I bake my lighting. So by using stationary or movable, I'm actually going to see that lighting information projected in real time, which is great. So we're just going to go ahead and set it to stationary. And down here, you can see in the source type, this is where we have our two options. Now, by default, it's captured scene. So if I set this to that, we'll change this up to 1, effects world. You can see here we're getting the same effect. What's happening here is the engine is actually capturing the scene from this skylight, which in this case happens to be outside of our scene. It's capturing that information and projecting it back into there. Okay, so you would think that that's an okay process, which it is. However, you don't really have full control over this because when you open your scene or you recapture it, that information could change. Now, that may be a good thing, that may be a bad thing. In this situation, we want to control it completely. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to switch this from captured scene to specific cube map. Now, if you notice, there's nothing there because we don't actually have a cube map. Now, a cube map, if you know anything about traditional game development, was typically a projection. Well, in this case, a cube map is an HDRI, so that's what we're going to use. So I've got one here that's relatively close. Let me actually open this texture and I'll show you. This is actually one that I grabbed from HDRI Haven website, has some great ones. And I'm just simply going to use a 2K, and it's very close to our scene. It has some similar props, but it's not 100% accurate. That's okay. And if you notice here, the compression settings is HDR. Now, when I imported this, it automatically recognized this was an HDRI. Okay, so I'm going to close that. And what I'm going to do is I can actually drag and drop this over here, or I can click from the dropdown. In this case, I'm going to go ahead and just do this. Okay, so now it's in our scene. I'm going to go down to our intensity and take this to about, we'll take it down to a 0.1 so it's not so blown out. Now, if you notice, the first thing is that it's actually adding lighting information to our scene, which is great. We want that. It helps to fill the ambience, which is good. You'll also notice that the light is actually projecting from the wrong side. Our windows are to the left. I can do this by rotating this source angle. So if you notice here, you can actually see the lighting effect that it has in real time. In this case, I'll probably rotate it over here, and there we go. So any place that I have reflective surfaces, so metal or, you know, not rough, that's where we're going to see a lot of this take effect. We'll also see it projected into the surrounding with some of that light. So again, if you recall, if I take this up, you'll see that it is actually, in fact, projecting light into our scene. Turn it off, turn it on, turn it off, turn it off. Okay. So this is great. So this is a way that we can apply the HDRI, but that's really not the point of this video. The point of this video is to show you how you can capture the elements in your scene. So actually capture an HDRI from your scene and project it back into the world. So now that you've got at least an idea about how this HDRI is going to affect the world, let's actually jump into the process of creating our own custom based on our scene. So we'll go ahead and do that right now. So what I'm going to do here is I'm actually going to go ahead and just reset all of our settings. So I'm going to reset source cube angle, and I'm actually going to remove this guy. Okay. I'm going to back up here just so we can see how to do this process. Now, the first thing that we're going to need is our skylight, which we have in the scene. So perfect. We're set up. We've got our mobility set to stationary, so we can see that dynamic lighting, as well as bake that lighting when we go to bake our lights. But now I actually want to go ahead and create the HDRI from my captured scene. So to do that, I'm actually going to go over here. If you try to look in any of these, you're not actually going to find the specific thing. In fact, we have to go to all classes, and if we scroll down to the S's, you'll see in here that we've got this scene capture cube. So I'm going to go ahead and throw this into the world. I'm going to press G to activate our game mode. And if you notice, it's actually a camera. Okay. So if you don't find it in all classes or something, you can always go just to basic and you can type in scene capture. And there we go, scene capture cube. Okay. So now that we have this camera in here, what we need to do is actually create our texture. So to do that, in fact, it's going to be a 360 projection, so it doesn't necessarily matter where the camera is facing. I'm just going to turn it around just because I kind of want to see it where it's facing forward. Okay, so I've got my camera here. Now what I need to do is this next process. So here I've got texture target. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to click this drop down and create a render target. And it's going to ask me where to save this file. So I'm going to go back to our maps, our HDRI, and I'm just going to name this scene01 HDRI. It doesn't matter, whatever you want to name it, you can change it later. So I'm going to go ahead and click save. And I'm going to go ahead and double click this image right here so we can see exactly what's happening. So if you notice, it's very similar to that other HDRI that we opened earlier in that it's actually capturing our scene. And to show you that, I can actually go in here and move this camera. And if you notice that the texture actually updates in real time. Okay, this is awesome. Cool, so you would think, that's it, I've got it, it's done. But not really. There's a couple more things that we need to do to really leverage this and actually create our HDRI. So the first thing that I want to do here is actually inside this this render texture. Now, by default, it comes in with a size of 256. So if you notice here, displayed as 512 by 256. If we open up our other one, you'll notice this actually comes in much higher. So I'm going to go back to our HDRI, and what I want to do is change this size X. I'm going to bump this up to, say, like 1024 to get me a lot higher fidelity resolution. So if I zoom in here, you can see we're capturing a lot more information. Okay, so I'll zoom back out here. Now, in order for us to actually create this texture, now that I've got this set up, I'm going to go ahead and right-click on our scene01 HDRI, and I'm going to say create static texture. As soon as I do that, I get this guy. Okay. So I'll come back to it, but if you notice, if I move the camera again, this guy's gonna be a little bit slower because we're capturing a lot more information. You can see as I move it, our scene01 HDRI, which we set up, is actually still changing, but our original capture has stayed the same. So it goes, so that's the process. Now that you've got the HDRI, you can export this, you can go in, you can change it in something else, give yourself better luminance values, whatever you want to do with it. But if you notice, by default in the engine, it's set to HDRI. Okay, perfect. I'm going to go ahead and close this. And what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to go ahead and delete our camera real quick. And then we don't need this guy anymore. In fact, if we open him, you'll see he's stationary. It's very important. One thing that I do want to make note of is if you notice, it's the colors are very close, but we have this dark pink and a light pink. The light pink is the texture. The kind of dark pink is actually the dynamic texture that you can't really use as an HDRI. So I'm going to go ahead and delete it so it doesn't confuse us. And there we go. Okay, so we have our HDRI. I'm going to go ahead and save it. Now, how do we actually use this? So what I'm going to do, I'm going to fly back down into this little circle here so we can see our reflections. Press G to go into game mode so we can hide all of those. I'm going to go back to our skylight. And if you remember how we applied the HDRI first, we're going to do the exact same process. So make sure my source type is set to SLS specific cube map. Stationary and movable so we can see the real-time lighting. And I'm going to go ahead and drag our HDRI into our cube map. And if you notice here, in our reflections, we actually have the HDRI that we captured. I've got this set to 1. You can see as I rotate this, you can actually see it's updating in real-time. So there we go. So we actually have our scene captured, which is pretty awesome. So now we know in any of our reflections, it's accurate to the scene, without using the SLS captured scene. So now we have full complete control over our reflections and our HDRI. Cool. Okay, so I'm not going to stop there, because one of the other things that I want to show you, which is very powerful about doing this, is how we can use multiple reflection captures in different locations to get different things. Now, you may ask the question, well, why would I want to do that? Well, if you have a fairly large complex scene that dips in and out of interiors and exteriors, your skylight probably isn't going to do you any good for the interior, say, if it's captured from the exterior, and vice versa. So what you want to have is more localized reflections and localized HDRIs. So I'm going to share that process right now. So I'm going to go ahead and go back to my skylight. What I'm going to do here is actually uncheck effects world, so we don't have that information being projected, and we can verify that in our reflection captures. So here and here, and there we go. I'm still going to use the same process, but instead of doing a skylight, I'm actually going to go over to our, I believe it's under visual effects, and I'm going to use this sphere reflection capture. Press G to go back into game mode, and what I'm going to do is just slightly position this over, and I'm going to substantially decrease the effect radius. So you can see here this outside bubble is the extent of what this can affect. So you see if I take this out, reflection capture goes down. Okay, so very similar to our skylight, by using the captured scene, we get pretty accurate results, and we can see that inside of our reflection. So by default, this is great. This is perfect, this would work, but I still want to have that individual control, and I think you already know where we're going with this. So what I'm going to do is change this to specific cube map on a reflection sphere, go ahead and drag our HDRI in there, and now you can see that if I move this, it still projects, but what is projecting is our actual cube map, which is great. So now this won't change when we open our scene or we go to, in fact, if you go up to here under build, normally when you do your full build with lighting, you also have this step here, which is build reflection capture. So you do that, it could change. That's the whole reason for why we're doing this, is because we want full control over it. So I've got this sphere, I've got this specific cube map, and what's great here, so if I take this guy, I'm just gonna duplicate and slide him here. You can see that I can still get those localized reflections. So if we were to take this a step further, you could take that virtual camera, you could move it around, move it to a corner here, recapture again. There may be something there like absolutely crazy, different lighting, different effects, you know, whatnot. Capture that HDRI, render it out, apply it to this reflection capture. Again, if you see if I move this off, then I'll have those localized reflections just in that area. So that's the process. That's how you can quickly create an HDRI from your captured scene and then apply it to your skylight or your reflection captures. So hope that helps. Catch you on the next one.